So we have Robin here today, and we are talking about implant placement and how we utilize all of the special new technology to have optimal implant placement. So before we ever started, Robin had presented to me, and she had a tooth that she had fractured, and so we had to remove that tooth, and in doing so, we needed to bone graft. And when we did the bone graft, we actually prepared some PRP when we were doing that. And by using the PRP is basically what that's called, platelet-rich plasma, okay, plasma. And so all the growth factors and special healing agents that your body harnesses to help itself recover and repair from injury, we can use that to help us in our procedure so that she can heal more effectively and more completely with fewer complications. One thing that I think is always really great is every time I do PRP for a patient, they have less pain afterwards. It's the one thing that I always notice whenever I make my calls to patients later that night and I talk to them, they always tell me, like, I didn't have any pain. Like, I'm feeling really, really good. And so that's always just, I think, like, really one of the best benefits of doing that procedure. So this is a CT of Robin before the implant was placed. And you can see that it gives a representation, if you look at the screen, all the different views that we have, the axial 3D coronal, and kind of my favorite is this sagittal view, but it shows the distance between the base of the bone and her sinus. And so we have a few millimeters here, and we need to know just exactly the correct width and depth that the implant needs to go to in order to serve as a solid anchor and long-term tooth replacement. So I have a surgical guide here, and the purpose of this surgical guide is to enable me to put the implant in the most precise position, okay? So traditionally, dental implants, the way they were placed, dentists would make an incision in the jaw. Okay, they would, like if the implant was going to go here, an incision would be made, and then the tissues would be pulled back from either side to expose the bone. And then the dentist would look at the site and kind of eyeball basically like where the implant was supposed to go. And the problem with that is sometimes it was good, and then sometimes when it healed, you're like, it's not really in the right position in order to put a tooth on it and have it look nice. So implants really need to be planned from kind of backwards, really. You start with how you want the tooth to look in the smile, and then you gauge that with where the bone is at after looking at the CT. And then you kind of marry all of those ideas together to decide where the exact placement should be. So the placement of the implant is really dictated by where the bone is at and all the vital structures. And we can use that scan and CT of the body to decide where the implant goes. And we can precisely place it. And when we do that, it's placed with minimal irritation to the gums. So for instance, I make just a little incision right where it goes, and that when I place it, it goes right through that area. So for instance, this is a surgical guide, and whenever we go to place the implant will be placed through that hole in the surgical guide. So there is no more of this making large incisions in the mouth and pulling the gums back to eyeball where it needs to go. It's all done very precisely, and the precision means fewer complications and less pain. So I am all for that. This guide acts like a roadmap to get us to where we need to go with respect to the smile, and the bone just really joins all of those aspects together to get precise placement.